Artificial intelligence, or AI, these terms are everywhere these days. Artificial intelligence refers to a machine's ability to imitate human activities, such as logical thinking, learning, planning, and creativity.
The first and the second industrial revolution were both about industrialization. That means the implementation, processing, generation, and use of energy. By analogy, one could say that the current revolution is doing the same, but for information instead of energy.
As a pioneer in the field, Bernhard Schölkopf is convinced that artificial intelligence will transform our lives more profoundly than all previous technological revolutions. But what is the difference to other major changes of the last 300 years?
Ich würde sagen, die jetzige ist dichter am Kern dessen, was uns als Menschen ausmacht, weil wir.
I would say that the current one is closer to the core of what defines us as humans. I don't think we are proud of being particularly good at processing energy. We don't believe in being stronger than other animals or to run faster. But we believe in being smarter, to process information better than animals. And that's why this revolution affects our self-image more, now that this kind of activity is being industrialized.
The mathematician and physicist Bernhard Schölkopf is one of the leading figures in the field of artificial intelligence. He is one of the directors of the Max Planck Institute for Intelligent Systems in Tübingen and professor at ETH Zurich. He is also the founding director of the first ELIS Institute in Tübingen. The aim of ELIS, short for European Laboratory for Learning and Intelligent Systems, is to advance cutting-edge research in artificial intelligence in Europe. Since 2018, Schölkopf has been a member of the Hector Fellow Academy. Bernhard Schölkopf has been doing research in the field of machine learning for many years. He studies how machines learn from data to solve certain problems or make decisions. To this end, Schölkopf and his team develop algorithms. That means instructions that enable computers to carry out an action on their own. He is particularly fascinated by identifying patterns in data and putting them into context.
The major theoretical topic is the learning of causal representations. That means images of the world. How can we mathematically understand that these images of the world, which we form in our minds, actually relate to the world itself? It is clear that everything we perceive as the world is created in our brains. We don't have direct access to the world. We have our senses, which translate into neuronal impulses, and then a construction is built.
Bernhard Schölkopf is also particularly interested in artificial intelligence in science. His methods and programs are used across numerous disciplines, from biology and medicine to economics and astronomy. Schölkopf's research on exoplanets and gravitational waves illustrates how machine learning can help to expand our understanding of the universe. A gravitational wave is a tiny ripple in space itself, the fabric of the universe that is created when something very heavy, such as two merging black holes, shakes space. Maximilian Dax's doctoral project is also related to this topic. Maximilian Dax is a young researcher at the Hector Fellow Academy and is being supervised by Bernhard Schölkopf in his research project.
Ich arbeite ja vor allem im wissenschaftlichen Bereich, also im KI für wissenschaftliche Entdeckung sozusagen.
I mainly work in the scientific field, in AI for scientific discovery, so to speak. And there are numerous applications in this area. For example, we recently had a project here at the Max Planck Institute focused on characterizing the atmospheres of exoplanets. Exoplanets are planets in other solar systems. Several thousand of them have been discovered so far. These exoplanets can be observed using electromagnetic telescopes, for example.
Studying the atmosphere of an exoplanet is particularly exciting because it might give insights whether they are similar to Earth and whether life could possibly exist there. Artificial intelligence opens up completely new perspectives in gravitational wave research. It helps to better understand what exactly happens when two black holes merge.
In my doctoral project, we are developing machine learning systems to analyze gravitational waves. The input to such systems is a gravitational wave measurement, such as those taken by the LIGO or Virgo detectors in the USA or Italy. We feed our tool with this gravitational wave as an input, and then the tool gives us an estimate of the astrophysical parameters as an output. In the context of gravitational waves, we would like to find out something about the properties of black holes or neutron stars.
The data therefore reveals where systems of neutron stars are located and how they are aligned. This allows us to direct telescopes to watch them merge in the sky at exactly the right moment. Artificial intelligence can analyze and evaluate large amounts of data that are too complex for humans. Bernhard Schölkopf is convinced of the enormous potential of AI, but also sees its risks.
For me, a big concern is how it affects opinion-forming processes, how it could affect elections. That is, if you have chatbots that can interact with millions, billions of people on a large scale, perhaps interacting in a way that is optimized for each individual, then an election is not the same as it used to be. No one can really predict what that will mean, how the balance of power will shift.
The impact on our society should not be underestimated. But what will happen to our world if artificial intelligence continues to evolve? Will intelligent machines take over one day? Or is this a nightmare scenario?
Dieses hypothetische Risiko, dass diese Systeme irgendwie plötzlich die Weltherrschaft übernehmen.
For me, this hypothetical risk that these systems could suddenly take over the world and control us because they are smarter than us is a science fiction scenario. I think it is dangerous because it distracts us from the real problems. We need to focus on the more realistic issues that are closer in the future. And I believe that if we build mechanisms, including international mechanisms, to deal with such risks, we will also be better prepared for long-term risks that might become relevant in 50 years.
The revolution of artificial intelligence is unstoppable. AI systems are omnipresent today and continue to be developed worldwide. We will use artificial intelligence more and more in our daily lives. AI not only reflects the world, but also actively shapes it. We must therefore ensure that the information fed into these systems is secure and correct. AI must not reinforce prejudices or discrimination due to historical or biased data. It must be developed and monitored continuously. Therefore, it is crucial to develop and apply AI expertise not only in countries like the US or China, but also in Europe. Bernhard Schölkopf is playing a key role in this endeavor with his wide range of projects.